Alright, ladies and gentlemen, as the majority of you might be already aware, a new patch has been recently released for the Blitzkrieg mode, version 4.9.6, adding Storm Tiger, Panzer III, as well as 30 new maps too. However, before we get into all this stuff, there is one game here that I really need to cast. This game is played on version 4.9.5. So basically, this is going to be the last version 4.9.5 game that I ever managed to upload on my YouTube channel. But I'm telling you this game is absolutely worth it. It's a one versus one, obviously, me playing as Wehrmacht against the player. Well, there is no way I could be able to pronounce his name correctly. However, he's actually my teammate. I used to play with him in the same team for a couple of times. We even have videos together. It's Boba playing as US, as US faction. And this is going to be an intense battle, a truly intense battle, one of the pissed games I have ever managed to play in Blitzkrieg, in the history of Blitzkrieg. Here he's advancing with his rifleman squad into my pioneer squad behind. Yeah, that's a really good flanking maneuver by him, advancing with his engineers from this side, his jeep suppressing, and then his riflemen rushing forward. A good grenade by me here almost killed his rifleman squad, but there's no way I could hold longer. Here, my PAK-36 missed the jeep quite carelessly. So, as far as you can see, this game is already having lots of fight. Just 2 minutes, and he's planting mines. I can see that he's planting some anti-personnel mines here behind those sandbags. I can see that very well. So I will be later destroying it with my Volksgrenadier squad. This jeep here, protecting this area of the map, having my Volksgrenadier as well as my Pioneer squad shooting at this engineer squad here. He's trying to flank with the jeep. Yeah, suppressing, almost suppressing my Pioneer squad, relocating my PAK-38. Now I have two Volksgrenadiers, one rifleman. Yeah, one rifleman squad yet. Two rifleman squads, alright. Two rifleman squads. This jeep here is hiding from my PAK-36. Well, these units here having a fight together. But yeah, the Carbiner 98 is going to win at long range. So he's deploying a sniper. Like I said earlier, this is going to be the last version 4.9.5 game I upload. After that, we will be moving to the new patch. What is so interesting about this game here is the fact that it was truly epic. There is nothing more that could be said about it. I honestly don't know how to describe it correctly. But this game was just amazing. There's not much to say about it. You just need to watch it until the very end. There's no joking here. This map here is actually consisting of 5 fuel points. One here, this fuel point, plus 9, this also plus 9, plus 4, plus 4, but he built an observation post. Well, no, it's actually plus 9. Plus 9, plus 9, plus 9, plus 4, plus 4. Yeah, so 3 fuel points, 3 high fuel points, and 2 low fuel points. This jeep here is trying to prevent my Volksgrenadiers from capturing this ammo point. My Volksgrenadiers are protected behind heavy cover, and here he already captured the fuel point. At the start of the game, I was rather very careful, advancing very slowly, as you can see. I think Boba managed to capture much more ground at the start of the game than I did, on the other hand. Here he's moving his sniper. Yeah, that's a pretty good tactic. Moving his jeep next to the building so that the Volksgrenadier squad can be revealed inside the building, and then the sniper from a long range shooting at my Volksgrenadiers. Instantly killing one man as they leave the building. This rifleman squad here is trying to advance, going for my PAK-38. I obviously had not enough ammunition to use. Well, I actually had 30 ammunition. Not quite sure why I didn't use high explosive shells. Pioneers shooting at the riflemen. Volksgrenadiers also shooting at the riflemen. Here, my Volksgrenadiers are just standing, well, staring at each other. They are not capturing the point. Well, that was a mistake. Shortly, I will be ordering them to capture it. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Here he captured this building. Let's have a look. Yeah, he captured it with Rifleman Squad. Again, my PAK-38 misses the Jeep while it's moving. And for the third time, he managed to escape. Can't be lucky more, I would say. Here is a PAK. Not a PAK. Actually, it's an anti-tank gun. US 37 mm anti-tank gun. I can pretty much here. Yeah, there we go. Here I'm throwing the grenade, killing his anti-personnel mine, which he managed to plant with his engineers earlier on the game. So far, a PAK 40. It's called PAK 30. Oh, yeah. This PAK is called PAK 36. This one is PAK 38. The whole time I have been saying PAK 38 on this one. Sorry for that. It's called PAK 36, not PAK 38. This is the PAK 38 50 mm anti-tank gun. So he has one sniper. I advance with my mortar, trying to kill his sniper. Yeah, now I can see it on the tactical map. He already realizes that my mortar is trying to kill his sniper. So he takes the advantage and sprint away from the mortar. So far, Boba has 3 fuel points captured, while I only have 2 fuel points on the other hand. Now I can see his anti-tank gun here with my spotter. He advances forward with his jeep as well as with his quad after killing his rifleman squad, but he's flanking with another rifleman squad. So far here my pack 38 positioning itself. But yeah, my opponent is not a new player. He's extremely expert, actually. I mean, I thought this game would be much easier, but I came to the conclusion that he's actually a pro player. I have to give him that. Are you going for a tiger again? Yeah, as I said earlier, he's actually my teammate. I played with him in the same team several times. He knows my playing style. Here my mortar is killing his rifleman squad. I really couldn't move to the next patch before casting this game here, because like I said, it's one of the very interesting one versus one games that I have ever had. Here's my here's his squad. Yeah, my pack shoots his squad, but it doesn't hit. His squad was faster to escape from the range of my pack 38. Here again, my pack hits the ground, hits the dirt. My mortar is trying to kill either his sniper or his US 37mm anti-tank gun, not sure. Yeah, he can't cross this line because, yeah, he can definitely see my pack 36. He can also see my pack 50mm with his spotter. Puma, 50mm Puma. He killed my Volksgrenadier squad with his squad, unfortunately. Hitting it, destroyed engine. Killed the quad. So yeah, that Puma is rather useful. Oh, look at that range! Ah, shit. While I was retreating with my Puma, this anti-tank gun managed to hit the rear. He got my light machine gun, trying to shoot my Volksgrenadiers behind heavy cover. And yeah, using HE shells with my pack 36, advancing with my pack 38 so that I could counter the Jeep. Here, anti-tank squad ambushing itself. A mortar half track. Now that's going to be very annoying. A sniper trying to kill my Volksgrenadier again. And yeah. As for doctrines, my opponent is going airborne doctrine, while I went for the Blitzkrieg doctrine on the other hand. I almost actually, well, I'm not going to burn the whole thing for you, so you should just keep watching it for yourselves. So he's trying to mortar my pack 38 with his mortar half track, but I quickly realized this, so I decide to reposition my pack 38. Here building sandbags with my Grenadier squad. It's the best tactic to build sandbags and to stay behind them while you are capturing any point. This mortar half track now is capable of shooting at my base, which is not considered base bombing because It's just a mortar, right? It's just a mortar. You can't. I mean, I can't complain if he shoots my pace with his mortar, because it's not a 105 millimeter howitzer. You know, guys, what I mean. So here he already. Well, he wasn't actually trying to hit my base. He was trying to kill my mortar team here. Again, this Jeep survives. My Pack 38 missed it. Shooting this rifleman squad with my sniper. Moving my Volksgrenadier forward, he advances with his Rangers, trying to capture this ammo point. Here I made a mistake. I actually forgot my Volksgrenadier standing behind heavy cover, and now the mortar shell is coming. Yeah, and they are dead. I also lost my sniper to his sniper, so yeah, that's quite high casualties over there. Not a bad idea advancing forward with my boomer, trying to, well, it missed, so driving backward as fast as I could to avoid the bazooka team. Yeah. Yep. He keeps abusing me with his mortar half trick. But now, as we can see, I actually have two fuel points. No, three fuel points. One, two, three. He has only two ones, which is rather an advantage. Now, yes, he decided to finally shoot my base using his mortar, which is something, like I said earlier, it's something that I cannot actually complain about, because later on I will be doing the same. Hitting your opponent base using mortars is not considered base bombing. Trying to hit his mortar half-track with my mortar team, but I believe his mortar is going to win. Not quite sure, I can't really remember. Yes, his mortar won the fight. Here my Grenadier squad is trying to break through, now relocating behind heavy cover. I totally forgot about this anti-tank. Yeah, that was careless. That was a reckless move by me, losing the boomer. That was not good. Now he's capturing this fuel point with his Ranger squad. Look at this guy. Anyway, so yeah, a 76mm anti-tank gun. I got my first Ostwind. So yeah, he is airborne doctrine, like I said earlier. Here he orders a reconnaissance flight into the borders of my base to see if there are any packs or anything that he could shoot with his airplanes. So yeah. Now I have my Ostwind trying. Yeah, he already figured out that my Ostwind is coming, so he's moving his anti-tank team to this side of the map. His sniper's absolutely annoying. Yeah, I got my LMG pack. He stole it earlier with his rifleman squad, but I killed his rifleman squad, and now I regained this light machine gun. I also deployed a mortar half-track. I didn't lose my mortar team either, So, two mortars versus one mortar half-track at the moment. He is still shooting my structures with his mortar. Two snipers, two anti-tank guns, one mortar half-track, a ranger squad, anti-tank team, jeep. What else? He's calling an airplane. Aha. Killing, holy shit. Killing my anti-tank squad as I was trying to rush this mortar half-track. Trying to shoot the mortar half-track with my Ostwind, as well as with my two mortars. Now he has control on pretty much the whole map, which is not good. But something is gonna happen. Something is gonna happen, and things will be different soon. He's advancing with his ranger squad into this building. I try shooting his rangers with my grenadier squad. Here's a grenade, really nice grenade. Here my mortar is trying to shoot his anti-tank gun. Yeah, I can see it with my spotter here. This jeep is still here. Yeah, the situation is quite difficult. But I'm not yet surrendered, so doing some sneaky, yeah. Now, yeah, as you can see, he called in a bombing airstrike, killing my Ostwind as well as my Pack 36. I think he was aiming for the mortar half-track, but somehow it survived. But now, as you can see, his ammunition is just 70, while my ammo is, on the other hand, well, 87, pretty much the same. Grenadiers having a fight against this rifleman squad. The mortar half-track will be supporting, yeah. This squad half-track is a real problem, no doubt. So, here I go for the combat support group, which is an off-map call-in. These bushes here got wiped out due to the mortar shells. So, I try advancing with my Panzer IV, as well as with my Grenadier squad. But yeah, taking some casualties, advancing with my Panzer he's a nice grenade, really nice grenade. Somehow he survived, though he barely survived. Shooting this bazooka team so I could move forward with my Panzer IV. And yeah. Ah, shit! He killed my Grenadier squad with his mortar half-track. Again, also, this bazooka team survives. I can see him advancing with his 76mm anti-tank gun, so I drive backward with my Panzer IV, and I advance with my mortar half-track. Trying to kill this jeep with my mortar team. So yeah, as you can see, I'm pretty sieged. He has control over the map, and Yeah. Such a very difficult situation. You can see my motor half-wreck trying to hunt his 76mm anti-tank gun, so he decides, yeah, luckily enough, his 76 missed my motor half-wreck. Here he's going for this fuel point, as I'm trying to prevent him from doing so. He has some snipers. Where are they? Where are his snipers? Yeah, one sniper here and another one here shooting my infantry. Yeah, this mortar half trick has 18 infantry kills right now. Well, but I successfully, yeah, I can see his airplane coming. He killed my officer. Well, he was aiming once again for the mortar half trick, but yeah, I saw it coming. So I quickly drived backward with my mortar half trick.
Let's put some fear into
wheels in grease, ready to go.
So far, shit, that was a bad idea. That was definitely a bad idea. Now I will be losing my Panzer IV. He also deploys a Sherman loaded with HE rounds. So yeah. He almost got me, I have to say. He almost got me. So yeah, he's continuing to surround me from all the sides. Yeah, he's even shooting my Parex with his 37 anti-tank gun. Stuk on the field, shooting the 37mm anti-tank gun. Also, my mortar half-track managed to prevent this Ranger squad from capturing the fuel point. And here I'm killing the 37mm anti-tank gun, ambushing my Stuk IV. Well, quite a decent defensive line I have created. Also, killing the 76mm anti-tank gun with my Stuk. Look at that range, from here to there. Yes, the Stuk 4 is a pretty decent defensive unit. If you compare the Stuk 4 with the Stuk 3, the differences are quite obvious. The Stuk 4 can ambush, and also has a 360 degrees rotating top MG gunner. So I really prefer the Stuk 4 over the Stuk 3 for many reasons. The Stuk 3 can be quite decent, so also because it's actually less expensive, has assault ability which can boost all infantry nearby, as well as really decent timed high explosive ability. Here trying to advance forward with my storm troops, as well as with my grenadier squad. Here my mortar managed to finally kill this jeep here behind this building. Trying to rush these snipers, he relocates his quad half-track, trying to protect the snipers. I throw a grenade, but the sniper has already crawled away. So yeah. So far, look at this mortar half-track. It has 23 infantry kills. Quickly suppressing my storm troops with his quad half track. And yeah, now I'm in such a very bad situation. I can't really advance. I can't really advance anywhere. Those two snipers, anti-tank guns, and also he has deployed some tanks. Where is his Sherman? There it is. Also a 76mm Sherman. And high explosive Sherman. There we go. Almost killed my Grenadier squad already.
Light mechanized here.
Two mortar half tracks shooting each other. Ah, shit. Ah, nice. This single shell costs 35 ammunition. If I'm not mistaken. So he recaptures this ammo point, shooting him with my mortar. I'm not quite sure. He could have probably advanced with his snipers a bit. Or probably this is not a really good idea because yeah, my mortars would be hunting his snipers. So yeah, he's doing the right thing. My mortar almost killed this rifleman squad, but he figures this out, so he retreats with his rifleman squad. So the only thing I really rely on throughout this game is so far the combat support group calling in tanks and infantry units from outside the map, trying once again. Look at this Tuk 4 damaged engine ambushed. When ambushed, this Tuk 4 has extra range, killing this Sherman 76. Relocating my Panzer 4. Damaged engine as well. Trying to kill. Pounced! My Panzer 4 pounced off. The Sherman. I mean, the Sherman. Again. Look at this. Oh, goodness. This Panzer IV would be dead right now. But thanks to this building, the Panzer IV survived the air bombing, the airstrike, thanks to this building. Literally. This Panzer IV could have been killed right now. Oh shit. That was lucky. Not really though, as I lost my Grenadier squad. Another airplane. It's just a reconnaissance airplane this time. Obviously I can't grab this LMG-42 with my Grenadier squad, because I already have this squad is fully equipped with two LMGs already, so I can't actually capture this LMG. So far, like you can see, what I mostly rely at is the ammunition trades as well as combat support group. Oh, hitting his quad half track. Only half health. Well, that's quite interesting. He is trying to shoot my PAC-38 with his mortar. This mortar has 25 infantry kills. My mortar, on the other hand, has 11 infantry kills. Well, I think he's going to kill my Pack 38. Actually, no, he didn't. 76mm Sherman pounces off the Panzer IV. Luckily enough. So yeah, he has two Sherman, 76 Shermans, as well as a high explosive Sherman, a quad half trick, and a mortar half trick too. One anti-tank squad, ranger squad, rifleman squad, and airplanes. Airplanes obviously are the most dangerous thing so far. Yeah, airplanes are the absolute enemy that I almost have no counters. I mean, I can deploy an Ostwind, but doing this would probably consume all my resources while I was trying to save up for the Tiger so I could advance. Well, he's trying to push me with his Shermans from this side. The Stug is ready, but yeah, that's too much distance. 26 infantry kills, goddammit. Well, so far he's repairing his mortar half track with his engineers. He's being too careful, I would say. He does not want to carelessly rush with his units, not to lose them instantly. Well, Sherman suppresses my both grenadier squads. Instantly suppressed. Not a surprise. Not a surprise at all. Well, from now on, I will be trying to just hold until I have my Tiger. Then we can see what would happen. He's trying to capture this fuel point. He probably can expect already that I'm saving up for the Tiger tank. Oh shit. Well. That was bad. He killed my Pyrex as well as my Stug ambushing nearby the barracks. Killed the engineer squad thanks to my mortar. 17 infantry kills. But now he's reorganizing his units. I believe he's going to advance. He's going to attack me soon. He will try to end this game. He will definitely try to end this game. So he has two mortar half tracks. This one has 27 infantry kills. While this one only has nothing, actually. So he's advancing with his ranger squad, his rifleman squad, 76 Sherman, as well as, well, yeah, my Panzer IV, my mortar half-track here is, yes, the 76 Sherman is trying to advance forward. Now he's attacking my base already. There's not much I can do. All I have is this Panzer IV and pounces. He penetrates me and my shot pounces. Mingun destroyed. Here we go. this Sherman. Ah, shit. Main gun destroyed again. This Sherman. Pounces. Pounces as well. Oh, shit. Who's going to win? Well, he successfully killed my Panzer IV. Also mortaring my base with his mortar Haftrex. Well, at this point of the game, we can pretty much say that he won, right? Well, this is not right. I managed to... currently I'm deploying a Tiger. I also managed to... Ah, shit. I also managed to call in another combat support group. My pack successfully killed the mortar Haftrek. My new Panzer IV killed the Sherman. This Sherman is also damaged. Killed it as well. Killed the rifleman squad. Killed the Quad Haftrek. Well, what happened here? He was not aware that I have traits. Traits can really turn the game. Both bazookas pounced of the Panzer IV. Here, thanks to my trades, I was able to bring more units. Killing his porter. Rushing with my infantry now. That's my chance. That's my chance to turn the game. Also, the Tiger is deployed. That's absolutely my chance to turn the game. Everything now is overturning. Here, my Tiger is advancing forward together with my Panzer IV. This Panzer IV is Veteran C level 2. So yeah, as you can see, the game has turned suddenly, and my Tiger is advancing. Killed the Sherman. Two bazookas here from this building almost killed my Panzer IV. I can see his anti-tank squad carefully advancing with my Tiger. Well, you might be wondering, why doesn't he use... Well, he actually penetrated my Tiger with his Sherman. Killed his Sherman. You might be wondering why he doesn't call in an airstrike. Well, I'm wondering the same. I'm really wondering the same. Now he does. It's an airstrike. Not just an airstrike. It's an air patrol. Fighter bomber patrol. But I escaped it. So yeah. My Tiger tank is safe. He lost too many. Just look at his manpower. Just 50 manpower. Now repairing my Tiger. And yeah, so suddenly I killed his Quad Haftrek, his mortar Haftrek here, and his second mortar Haftrek here, his two Shermans, and also a Sherman here, and a Sherman here. Suddenly, well, he didn't repair his tanks, and suddenly I was able to gather more units. So that was quite unexpected from his side. Yeah. He thought he's going to win this. But yeah. Not versus me, buddy. Killing his porters. Hiding behind this building. As I already assume that his sniper is located here. Now... I finally had my chance to recapture the whole map. Advancing with his squad, together with his ranger squad, killed his squad. He was careless, driving too close with his squad, with his quad half-track, to my storm troops. He probably didn't notice that my storm troop actually has a Panzer Schreck. He didn't notice that my storm troop has a Panzer Schreck, so now I killed also his observation post. This ranger squad managed to bin my stormtroop squad here. A grenadier squad is having a fight with his ranger squad. So far the grenadier squad is superior. Now I was repairing my Tiger. Already veterancy level 1. This Panzer IV is still veterancy level 2. Also my motor half-track is veterancy level 2. So yeah, everything but a target. I somehow managed to turn the game, thanks to trades, like I said earlier, and also this Panzer IV really arrived at the right time. Most of his tanks were damaged at this point when this Panzer IV arrived. So that gave me quite a decent advantage to turn everything. Now my mortar half-track is trying to kill this sniper. He is deploying more and more Hillcats. One Hillcat behind this tree, another Hillcat next to this small tree. Well, it's kinda weird that a Hillcat ambushes just under this small tree. Well, does this actually make sense? Well, but anyway, it's just a game, and yeah, he's ambushing his Hillcat. I also captured my second mortar, and yeah, we two sniper. He has an MG now. I can see his MG. My mortar will be shooting this MG soon, and yeah, my Tiger is hopefully out of his sight, out of his line of sight, so he can't see it. Because if he sees my Tiger, an airplane is instantly going to bomb my Tiger. Yeah, now he has a spotter there. He also retreated with his MG. My Grenadier squad is trying to prevent this Ranger squad from capturing the ammo point. Tiger advancing. Almost killed his ranger squad, but somehow he survived. This ranger squad survived too many times, by the way. He can't see my Tiger. That's why he's not calling in an airstrike over my Tiger at this point. His engineer squad almost got wiped out instantly. My mortars are trying to sweep the area of any hostile units. I'm just shooting blindly at this part of the map. So if you take a look now at the map, things have been different. Yeah, he had almost the whole map. Now I have almost the whole map on the other hand. So yeah, Stug 3 arrived from the battle, from the combat support group. Now I'm being careful, very careful actually, because I don't want to lose all my units suddenly, like he just lost his units while he was attacking my base. So I'm kinda trying not to repeat the same mistake he did when he was attacking my base. Now this Ostwind, yeah, Ostwinds are absolutely necessary while playing against airborne, so that you could counter airplanes. I almost lost this Grenadier squad, damn it. So yeah, now I am surrounding him the other way around. He was surrounding me, but now I am surrounding him. Another MG, two MGs. Yeah. Those snipers. Ah, damn it. Storm troops for the win. They look so nice. Well, so yeah, trying to break through here with my Ostwind. He's advancing with his Hillcat, trying to counter my Ostwind. My Tiger is away. I should have moved it. Damn it. He's also trying to catch my Mortar Half-Track, but his Bazooka missed my Ostwind. I changed it to AB rounds. AB rounds can actually penetrate the Hillcat. This pack 38. Well, I lost my pack 38 to the Ranger squad. The Tiger is advancing forward. Stormtroop is advancing as well, trying to kill this Hillcat. Pinned on the ground. Now I will be shooting. Yes, killing this MG team. Now the situation is getting worse and worse for my opponent. He has, I believe he actually has enough ammunition, yeah. He has enough ammunition to call in. Aha, my Tiger pounced both the recoilless rifle as well as the Hellcat. Killed the Hellcat, now I drive backward with my Tiger. An airplane coming, and here it is going to hit my Tiger, and the Tiger, I lost the Tiger, unfortunately. But this Tiger definitely killed some units. It wasn't for nothing. And now, shit. I can't see his Hillcat. That's a nice, really nice ambush by his Hillcat. Killed my Panzer IV. He killed my really nice ambush from his Hillcat. I can see his Hillcat coming. Main gun destroyed. Recoilless rifles. Missed the Stug. He's going for my Mortar Half-Track as well. So, even though I managed to turn the game, my opponent is still resisting. And he is trying to not let me win the game. Explosive shells. That's what is really good about this Tug 3. Like I said earlier. Now, shooting this Ranger squad with my Grenadiers, also advancing with my Stuk 3 so I could support my Grenadier squad. And yeah, he missed my mortar half trick. And yeah, I'm actually deploying another Tiger. Yeah, I'm deploying another Tiger. He's still resisting. This sniper has 33 infantry kills, Veteran C level 3, 82nd Airborne Squad. Ah, shit. Shit, shit, shit. He almost killed. Yeah, he almost killed my Grenadier squad. Yeah. A very intense battle, no doubt. He's shooting my storm troops. This game is epic, I'm telling him. I have almost the whole map right now. He's completely surrounded, even though he killed my Tiger. He's still completely surrounded. There's not much he can do. Trades, again, using trades and combat support group. Grenade almost killed his 101st Airborne Squad. This sniper, absolutely annoying. I can't see his 82nd Airborne Squad rushing my tank. High explosive rounds, but it missed. Ah, shit. Pounced. Luckily, the Panzer IV survived. So yeah. Tiger is ready. I have enough. I have enough infantry squads. Enough tanks. As well as. I have enough units, thanks to the trades. Really enough units, thanks to the trades. That's what probably, I mean, like really, probably that's what made me win this game. This game is going to an end. He's trying to flank my Tiger with his recoilless rifle. But his recoilless rifle is rather helpless. Helpless against my Tiger. It can't really penetrate my Tiger. There we go. Three tanks. Infantry units are reinforcing. Here's another airplane coming. Another airplane coming. Damn it! barely survived. His Hellcat pounces off. My Tiger pounces off the 76mm of the Hellcat. My Panzer IV is advancing. Like you can see, I have the whole map. He's completely surrounded. High explosive rounds, I believe? Or, yeah, high explosive rounds. High explosive rounds. MGs. GG. GG. Indeed, that was a GG. My Tiger pounces. My Tiger pounces the 76. Killed the Hellcat. So yeah, now the game has pretty much, and I even didn't move my two infantry squads here. So far, this Tiger, Here, the game ended. My opponent decided to surrender. Because, yeah, so far the whole map is mine. He can't do much. I have one tiger, a Panzer IV, enough infantry squads, a mortar half-track. Oh, well, this mortar half-track has 31 infantry kills. He lost so much suddenly. The game was turned. I hope you really enjoyed this game. And yeah, a really epic game, isn't it? I really couldn't imagine I would ever win this game. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed, and see you on the next one.